Good morning everyone. Today we are going to learn about the new concept data handling. You are very interesting to learn this chapter. Okay, so the first one, data handling and probability. In this year we have learned one more concept, probability. You know about the data, is it? What is the definition of data? The information in the form of numerical figure, is it? That is called the data. It has two types. Are you remember that? Yes. What are the primary data and secondary data, is it? So primary data means the data collected directly from source, is it? One of the example, and voter list, collect the census list, population of a census list. Okay, so we have using the primary data method, is it? The employee come directly and meet the particular persons directly, is it? Then get the data. Okay, that is called the primary data. And secondary data, what is that? Secondary data, the data collected from external sources, like TV, is it? Television, magazine, okay, newspaper, okay, these are all the secondary data. Okay, and next we have seen the frequency. That's also we have learned in the last year, is it? Frequency means the number of times occurs the event. Number of times occurs the event or data is called the frequency. Okay, and next we have learned the tabular method, is it? We have learned tabular in the last year, is it? The tally mark method, is it? Remember, so classify into three columns. The first one we have considered these marks. Okay, so first one represent the marks, okay, and second one the tally mark, and third one represent the frequency, is it? How many times repeated? Okay, so frequency, the persons, how many marks? So for the marks, first one is 13. So 13 marks etra per eduthirukanga, 1. So you all write 1 tally mark and the frequency also 1. And next one of that, which mark? 25. How many of them? 2, is it? So you will write 2 frequency, the tally mark we have draw 2 vertical lines. And then 27. 27 is only 1. And 30, so one time. 38 also one time. Okay, 40, how many times? 3 times. So here at 3 times, this all we have learned in the previous class. And also we have learned the previous year about the representation of the graph, is it? Representation of data, is it? How to represent the data in the bar graph, pictograph, we have learned in the previous year. What is the definition of the pictograph? Pictograph means the data or informations represented in the pictorial, the form, is it? Pictures is called the, pictures or symbols is called the pictorial. Okay, and next we have learned the last year about the bar graph, is it? We have learned some rules followed for draw the bar graph, and we also learn about that. Okay, right. Now see the remaining types we have learned briefly in this year.
See the representation of data. We have learned the pictograph and bar graph. See that the pictograph. Okay, in a pictograph, numerical data is represented by the pictures. This we have learned well in the last year. And also we have learned about the bar graph in initial one. Is it how to draw the bar graph? Is it so? In a bar graph, the numerical data is represented by bars. It also called the bar chart. Okay, and next one of that, so presentation of data in many way. Okay, so third one of the method, the histogram. So nothing but the difference between the bar graph and histogram. Here the bars having the in equal gap in bar graph, is it? But here in adjusted one enna senjirukku join panni irukku. Okay va, in a histogram a frequency distribution is represented by joining adjacent bars. Okay, so graph bar graph la epdi irukuma, epdi irukum illaya? But here adjacent bars. Do you difference, understand the difference between the bar graph and histogram? That is the difference. Here joining the adjacent bars. Okay, pi means circle. Okay, so pi graph a numerical representation. Okay, numerical representation in a circular form. It is also called a pie chart or circular graph. And final one, line graph. In a line graph numerical data is represented by lines. Here the graph is represented by the line. Okay, so we have joined like this. Okay, line here represent the data in the circular form as components. Okay, it's in 360 degree. It's in 360 degree. Okay, so it is a pie graph, histogram, line graph. You all learn in the 8th and 9th standard. In the 8th standard, you have learned the histogram and pie graph. Line graph, you have learned in the 9th standard. Okay, so in this year we have learned briefly about the bar graph. Okay, so now we have recaptured the last year. Okay, now see one of the example related to the pictograph. Okay, everyone see the board. Okay, so I have shown one picture, is it? Neem tree. Okay, neem trees is 5, coconut tree 2, Ashoka trees 3, mango trees 4. Okay, so how can you represent this in the pictograph? See the next. Okay, yes, neem tree, we have consider 5 trees, so we have to draw the 5 pictures. Okay, coconut tree present 2. Okay, and Ashoka tree 3, mango tree. This is called the pictograph. Okay, right. Next to see another one of the example. Okay, so the same one, the number of persons in your neighborhood are as follows. So men vandu 40 members irukanga, women 30 members, children 60. Okay, how many children? 60. The above data can be represented in the pictograph as follows. See this picture. Scale, we have consider one moj, one smile face is equal to 10 persons. Okay, so see men first, we have 40. So how many moj we have to draw? 4. Why do you draw 4? We have to draw 40, is it? No, because we have consider one moj is equal to 10. So 4 moj we have 40. And how many men? 30. So we have draw 3 smiles. Okay, and children 60. So we have draw 6. Okay, I hope you understood. Now see the revision exercise. Now see the revision
exercise. Okay.
Revision exercise. The read the first one. Okay. Take the page number 230. Read the following pictograph of the production of cars and answer the following questions. Okay, so each car represents the 600 cars. Okay, so car A 3 is given. So 600 means 1800 cars in car A. Okay, so car B 4 cars. 4 cars means how many of them? 2400. Okay, and next one, car C 5 cars, so 3000. Car D is a single car only is given, so 600. Write the answers for each question. First question, which model is most popular? So which one is most popular? C one is that, is it? 3000. So the first one, car C. Okay, B. How many model C car were manufactured? So totally 3000. How can write the 3000? Here 5 cars are there. Okay, 5 each represent. So one car represent the 600 cars, is it? So here give at the 5 cars. So 5 multiple of 600 is equal to 3000 cars. In this place, car. Okay, here represent the 5 cars. Okay, right. And next is C. Which model is least popular? So it's car D. Car D is a least popular. Okay, right. See the second one. The following pictograph represent the number of animals in the zoo. The first represent the tiger, second elephant, monkey, deer. Okay, the scale is given. So one picture represent the 10 animals. Okay, so read the pictograph and answer the following question. First one, how many elephants are there in a zoo? Only one diagram is given. So one animal represents the 10 elephants. Okay. So second one, solution. A, 10 elephants. B, what is the total number of animals in the zoo? Total we have calculated. Okay, now first tiger, how many of them? 30, is it? Tiger 30. Okay, and next elephant, 10. Okay, monkey 50, deer 30. So total 40, 70, 120. So B one answer, 120 animals in the zoo. Okay, right. And see problem, which animal has the largest population in the zoo? Which one? Monkey, is it? It has 50. Okay, so which one? Monkey is the largest population. Okay, see the third one. Draw the pictograph for the number of students of the school in the different classes. Okay, so we have draw the pictograph for this class in it. Okay, for the class 6th to 12th is given.
pictograph we have draw. First, draw the table. Okay. The class. Number of students. Okay, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th. Okay, so now how many students? So we have considered this scale. Okay, scale we have considered. S equal to 20. Okay. So 1 represent the 1. This picture represent the 20 students. Okay. Right. So first one, 6 to 200. So how many pictures we have draw? 200. So 10. Okay. So 10 pictures we have draw. Five, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, 10 students. And 10 students means, so one picture represent the 20. So 10 into 20, 200. And seventh one, seventh standard 135. So we have drawn 6, is it? Yes. 120, 40, 60, 80, 100, 120. Okay, we need the 135. Okay, so 15 only we have need. So I have draw this one. I have removed this two legs. Okay, 4 minus 5. Okay, right. And next one, 80. 8 standard 160. Okay, 160 means we have draw 8 figures. Okay. Right, 6, 7, 8. So 160. Okay, 160. 8th standard 160 students, and 9th standard 325. So how many of them we have draw? 16. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Okay. 15, 16. So 16 2s are 32, and one more is there. Is 5. Okay. The stick only we have considered the 5. The stick. This one, okay. Stick we have considered 5. Okay, now draw. You will draw any picture, okay? So properly write the picture's scale, okay? The picture represent which one, which measurement represent. So clearly write in this scale, okay, ma'am? Right, that's it. Now see next one, which standard is given? 10th standard, is it? 10th standard, how many of them? 280 students. So 280, so we have draw the 14, is it? 14, 2s are, okay. 14 2s are 28, so 0 added 280. Okay, we have draw 14, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Okay. So next 11th one, 11th how many students? 170 students, okay. How many students are there? 170 students. So how many pictures we have draw? Eleventh standard, 170. So 8, is it? 8 2s are 16, so 0.5. So we have draw 8, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and one more stick only. Stick represents only 5, okay. So 170, okay. And 12th standard, 12th standard, how many pupils? 150 students. Number of students is 150, okay. So 115 means 7 students, okay. Each students represent 20, okay. So 7 2s are 14, 140, okay. And 110 we have represented like this, okay. Whatever you have, include the picture, you will represent the scale, okay. So we have draw 7, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The 10th for we have draw like this, okay. That's it, okay. Right, the 4th one, draw the pictograph for this stationery items purchased by the Rohan for his shop, okay. You will draw the pictograph for this diagram, okay. And 5th one also, we have to draw the pictograph, okay, Emma. So I have given 2 problems, homework from the revision exercise. Revision, okay, revision exercise 4 and 5. Okay, 4 and 5 are homework and also worksheet 1 homework. Okay,
worksheet 1 also homework. So today we have learned about the previous year concept. Okay, I hope you all remember it, and also I hope you all understood this concept. If you have any doubt, you can ask your doubt to me. Thank you, students.